Be off with you.
Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley has been dead these 7 years.
In fact, he died 7 years ago this very day. Well, we have no doubt that his generosity is well represented by his surviving partner. At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable that we should make some slight provision for the poor and destitute.
Are there no prisons?
Plenty of prisons.
And the union workhouses, are they still in operation?
They are. I wish I could say they were not.
And the treadmill and the poor law, they're still in full vigor, I presume?
Both very busy, sir.
Oh, from what you said at first, I was afraid that something had happened to stop them in their useful course. I'm very glad to hear it.
I don't think you quite understand us, sir. A few of us are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth.
Why?
Because it is at Christmas time that want is most keenly felt. And abundance rejoices. What can I put you down for?
Nothing.
You wish to be anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. Since you ask me what I wish, sir, that is my answer. I help to support the establishments I have mentioned. Those who are badly off must go there.
Many can't go there.
And some would rather die.
If they would rather die, they'd better do it and decrease the surplus population. Besides, it's not my business.
Isn't it, sir?
No. It is enough for a man to understand his own business without interfering with other people's. Mine occupies me constantly. Good afternoon, gentlemen. I'm turning, 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 turning.
In the great financial crash of the early 30s, Americans learned in a wounded bewilderment how fleeting a thing is security and how far from the frontier they had come.